got a doll baby. I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. A man, she's anything but calm.
Hello, everyone. K7 here with some more game streaming. In this one, we continue our story mode fun. And we are following Nick Valentine to the Memory Den to see what made Kellogg tick. As you can tell, we're already there at Good Neighbor. Make sure I got everything good. Special. Oh, yeah. The other night I started making supply routes between my settlements. And what that does is you essentially send one of the residents there to essentially walk to the other settlements, and it ends up sharing materials, which is absolutely wonderful if you're trying to set up a settlement. Don't need to be searching around trying to scavenge things when you can just have your giant stash from Sanctuary work for all of them. All right. So we're in here, and apparently everyone's down at the bottom.
Here for Amari. She's downstairs.
Okay, then. Yep. Downstairs. Oh, there's Nick Valentine.
Hey, Valentine.
Let's go talk to Amari.
There we go. Yeah.
Let's see what Amari is up to.
Right? Is he drunk? Okay, I guess he's not going down there. Oh.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. Wait. I remember you.
Oh, look at all this.
Inducement. Vault.
Let's grab this one. Get Grognak the Barbarian.
111, right? What's this all about?
You're the one who can extract memories from a brain, right?
Normally, we only allow our clients to experience their own memories. Now, what's this all about?
We need a deep dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse.
Let's up the volume here.
You don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Isn't there some way to make this work?
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
How much of the brain do you need exactly?
That is not an encouraging question. I suppose I'll have to make do with whatever you can find.
Let me just pause this right here for a second. I need to up the volume a little bit. Way too quiet. Ooh. Go into settings. Yo. Let's up the voice. Feeling very quiet.
Could you say that like Dr. Frankenstein?
Ego, fetch me the brain. No?
No, I will not. Now, do you have it?
No, I will
Here's
not.
Here's what I could find.
There we go.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Their circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Nick's an older model synth. Is he compatible?
That's exactly what I was thinking. If we are lucky, it should hook right in. But even if this works, Mr. Valentine would be taking on a tremendous amount of risk. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. Let's do it.
You really think this'll work, Nick?
No idea. But we got a missing kid on the line. That's worth the risk.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine.
This guy's awesome.
Just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Ooh.
Is Nick gonna be okay?
Yes, the connections appear to be stable. Hopefully, it'll be as simple as unplugging the implant once we're done. But that doesn't get around the current problem. The memory encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Because science.
Any idea what I'm going to see in there?
I have no clue. But considering we only have a single piece of the medial temporal lobe and not the whole brain, I doubt it'll be cohesive.
Nick and I are going to share a mind? Yeah, I'm not going to see him in any compromising positions, am I?
Yeah, if a smart mouth was all it took to solve problems, we would have found your son by now.
No. You won't have to worry about that. The only memories you'll access are the ones in the implant.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Nick.
Sit down if you're ready. Let's do this.
Hey.
What you got? You look like you could use a little pick-me-up.
Your thoughts?
This beats mayoral duties any day of the week.
Nothing else for now.
Yeah, sure.
There we go.
Dr. Amari.
Just sit in the memory lounger when you're ready.
Memory lounger. And now is the time when I go run around and do more side quests. I mean, I can't quick save while I'm doing this. This kind of reminds me of the pods from Fallout 3.
Migration between the transplant
Tranquility course. Lane. There
the
we go.
Activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
Huh. You gotta fight a little girl, a psychotic little girl in here, and there's a problem.
Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Rippy.
Turn down the goddamn radio!
Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but, people always hoping for something better. Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but, she loved me in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left. I didn't want to know. Not then. People always hoping for something better.
Hmm.
They usually end up with something worse. I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked?
It was always.
I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though. Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
Huh.
I'm sure that's gonna take some getting used to for a lot of people.
What a joke. What's it mean, Mom? Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe. Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days, like before the big war. Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless, but you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio, all useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
Memories.
It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah. You've got to give it a chance. Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter?
Oh, I actually paused it.
No, I never deserved her. Not for one second. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer. The thing about happiness is you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever.
Let's keep looking.
It's only looking back
to the next intact memory.
By comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like.
I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
I know, but that's where I come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those?
All the babies look the same.
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen. It's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got her.
Yet he has the job kidnapping other kids. Huh.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you...
I found
weren't
another
there
memory to
try. Help them.
I'll connect you.
Huh. That probably has to pertain to Fallout 1 or 2. Can't remember. Can't pin it, though.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself. I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. It was almost always a bar, though. That's universal. It was always a job for someone like me. Didn't matter what it was. Didn't matter who I was supposed to kill. I got pretty good at it. There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. I just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end. One way or another. I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
Huh.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you. And you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed. And I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Suited me just fine. First synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute.
So,
I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
You're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I can see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
Systems offline.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated.
This one again.
I'll try to locate another memory as quickly as I can. Please try to remain calm.
That's good. Checking through the logs.
How's now? The Institute's main... Eggheads never... How's now? The Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so... this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really.
Hopefully it's all...
Eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me, and I made sure they knew it.
Justin, find it.
Eggheads never liked taking orders from... I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders.
Oh.
Guess the old man didn't want so many
loose
ends.
That's what happened. That's why everyone else died.
Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too.
Huh.
If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long.
Hmm.
I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of, her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but, still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive. I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. I guess the old man didn't want so many... Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some... soft, pre-war vault dweller.
I think his gun is a little awkward.
Somehow got thawed out. At least I know those.
Maybe he has a wrist lock.
Bastards will soon get what's coming to them too. If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost.
Everything's gonna be fine.
Come here. Come here, baby.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here and let's go. At least we still have a backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup?
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
Oof. I had to relive that like 3 times already.
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory. So, good news, I think.
Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid, like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
I probably shouldn't have used, Kellogg.
It's okay. The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter, stronger, and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side. One of these days, you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
X688. Ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
The hell?
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
Special here. No. Can't interact with any of the comics. Hmm.
Kellogg.
It's okay. One of these days you're gonna get...
Huh. Oh, so it just repeats. Alright.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Am I okay? Are you seeing anything bad?
Don't be alarmed, but I honestly don't know what to look for. As I said before, this is uncharted territory, but your neural and physiological readings have returned. Are you ready?
You were along for the ride, weren't you?
Yes, but it's important.
Uh-huh. I saw Kellogg's life.
That's right. He was a human being. How does that make you feel?
Does it really matter how I feel, Doctor?
Yes. You can't.
Uh-huh.
We're getting off track. The only question is...
Mm-hmm. What do you think we should do?
What about that memory involving Virgil?
There's gotta be another way.
We delved into every
Uh-huh. I don't know. I'm not even sure we can try.
The memory gave us a starting point. The glowing sea. But that...
Mm-hmm. Why? What makes the glowing sea so dangerous?
The name says it all. Radiation. Navigating radioactive hazards is nothing new.
Uh-huh.
That's why it doesn't make sense.
Right. That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak. A way.
Sure.
If Virgil found a way to survive there, you...
How do I fight that much?
There are chemical compounds. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or...
Oh, I'm going in naked. Fingers crossed I get superpowers.
I know you're joking, but as a doctor, I feel obligated to remind you that unprotected radioactive exposure will only kill you. Dead. D-E-A-D. So be sure you find a way to get through there. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Remove the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Amari.
Be careful of the radiation.
The glowing sea
isn't a place to be caught unprepared.
Hey.
Yeah?
Hey, Hancock.
What's on your mind?
Your thoughts?
Plying Kellogg's gray matter must have been a wild ride.
Mm-hmm. Your thoughts?
Nice to not have to come.
Oh, nothing.
Yeah, sure.
It never hurts to have one more safe, reliable place. An anti-radiation.
Sounds like the Minutemen may be getting back on their
feet. Grab all of the stuff I can do. And that's I got the hiccups right now, and I don't know why.
Anyone willing to take a stand for safety in the Commonwealth is okay in my book.
Careful. You don't know where that's been.
Sure, why not?
Here she is, without the sight.
Bone.
Dr. Amari.
You have to find Virgil. A renegade Institute scientist could finally give us the insight we need.
Awesome.
First time here was so, well, all I can say is that you're very brave.
Hey, Irma.
Oh, enjoying yourself in Good Neighbor? It's a heck of a town, ain't it? You like the decor? My business partner hates it. Says she's not the fun type.
Sorry, Shroud. I don't have any upgrades ready.
Nick.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. That was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
You want to try for round two? Let's go!
What? What are you talking about?
You feeling all right, Nick?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
Wait. Were you just playing a joke on me?
I guess that's for you to wonder and for me and Kellogg's memories to know for sure. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going. Or I could head back to Diamond City, since you've got company already.
We have to head into the Glowing Sea. Any advice?
I'm a synth, so radiation isn't much of an issue for me, but an old suit of power armor might just be the guardian angel you're looking for. That, or you could buy up all the Rad-X and Rad-Away you can find from any chem dealer who's got it in stock.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far. Let's see where it takes us next.
Hey.
Do something for you?
Nick.
Do something for you?
Your thoughts?
A Commonwealth's not an easy place.
Sure. That's all.
All right.
Hey, Cock. Get away. Huh. I guess he did.
Good neighbor. Lowest place in the Commonwealth. Everything not nailed down rolls through here at some point.
Whoever this Brotherhood of Steel is,
Hancock.
Look who it is.
Peace.
You heading out again?
Let's do it.
Done.
You two stay out of trouble.
Come on, Nick. You know I don't.
Valentine Detective Agent. There we go.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road?
You interested in traveling together?
Would be nice, the two of us getting out there again.
Not now.
Well, I'll be around if you change your mind.
Ooh.
You know who kicked the ghouls out of Diamond City, right? That blowhard, Mayor McDonough. He'll get it.
Alrighty. Well,
is one day.
That is pretty much everything for that segment of the quest. I think that this is a good place to cut it off for now. Got to see everything that was going on, so we'll pick this up at another time while I go play around some more with my settlements. For those who tuned in, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye now. Squeeze them, they don't even know my name.